Vanakkam, namaskaram, and humble salutations. You are watching Mzansi's ultimate Hindu magazine program right here on SABC3. M. Kayanga Jan continues on our usual slot with Bhagavad Gita chapter 14, and so does Anuradha on conscious cooking. Interestingly, today we meet a group of passionate Tamil students in Amkumas as well. But first, we understand the intricacies of Carnatic music with Karthigesan Pillai and family. Yes, recently we featured Sri Karthigesan Pillai's phenomenal musical journey. During our time with him and his musical family, we picked up the term, the maths of music. Quite intrigued, we decided to find out more.
I think at the outset when I met Karthigesan, even before marriage, I realized that his passion, his first wife was music. And I came secondary. And I think that still is, or maybe now I've moved to third place after Kirtan, because the two of them really gel together and everything is about music at home.
I didn't wake up one morning and music was sitting on the plate for me to eat, but I learned a lot from my dad, not sitting down on the floor and him sitting in front of me, but the little bit time that every single moment that we got together, it was always music. For 2 years, during the time that I was learning mridangam, I never touched a mridangam. That was my grade five and six, when I was going to the Satya Sai school. My tuition was only calculations. My father's project was to make me a scientific calculator in music. Hopefully I do get there one day. For those 2 years, it was only calculations. Waiting for the traffic at Petroport just to learn. That was exactly what it was. Getting hit with the left hand, getting hit with the right hand, stopping the car to get hit if the calculations was wrong. And I think that's exactly what mridangam playing is, a lot about calculations.
By finger counts and claps, we are governed by the system, thalam system, when we sing. And the thalam goes like this: clap, two, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is 8 matras or 8 counts. Basically, in each matra, there's 4 aksharas or 4 beats, which total this complete thalam to 32. So, adi thalam or chatusra jadi tirupudi thalam, when we're singing a song like, I take a bhajan like Sai Ramba Jomana, and I will sing it according to the thalam. The starting of the line and the completing of the line, you will see it on the thalam. Sai Ram Bajo Mana, Sai Ram Bajo Re, Sai Ram. You will know the thalam started on the clap and it ended off with a wave. And then it gets back. And it's a rotation, continuous effort with the thalam. So we are governed with this. And it goes on in depth. Gamakam is actually waves, you know, the slight waves on your voice, that two swara or two note. Example, if I sing a swara, sarika. Now, if you do that in agara sadhagam, or means in a form, this is basically what it is. And this gamakam is called arognam gamakam, because it's going on a ascending note. There are panchadasa gamakams, and now it's come down to dasavita gamakam. Panchadasa means 15 and dasavita means 10. So there's ample gamakams in Carnatic music and also Hindustani music. We cannot say only in Carnatic music. Hindustani music, there's also Shastri Sangit, there's gliding notes as well. So to sing a swara in South Indian or Carnatic music and in North Indian music or Shastri Sangit. In Carnatic music, ragam Kalyani. In North Indian or Shastri Sangit, it's a very mellow glide in Hindustani music. and a very forceful glide in Carnatic music.
Kirtan began drumming literally when he was in my tummy. His dad would sing, I think it's the same Varnam that he sang today. He'd sing that and Kirtan would kick to according to the sound of the music. And even if he said the solo cut is of the mardangam, Kirtan would kick to the beat of whatever he was reciting. And basically, Kirtan grew up living on stage. At that point, when he was growing up, we lived in Johannesburg, and there was no family there with us. So when we performed, I had no choice but to leave him on stage, sleeping in a little carry cot. And every now and then, he'd wake up and sit next to us and sometimes interfere with one of us, which became entertainment for some people, while for some people it was a disturbance. But there was no choice. If they wanted Karthikeyan to perform, I was his accompanist, and there was no place for us to leave Kirtan. So Kirtan was there with us on stage, sleeping or either providing some sort of entertainment for the audience.